Hi. So are you looking for a career in publishing house? I have the right person for you today. She is none other than Swati Chopra. She is the associate publisher in HarperCollins. Imagine such a big publishing house. So welcome to my show, Swati. It's really wonderful to have you here.
Thank you. It's a pleasure to talk to you.
Same here. So please tell us about the career options which are available in a publishing house.
So publishing, actually in India, there is English language publishing, and there are various Indian languages that also have their publishers. So since my experience is with an English language publisher, I will talk about that.
Right.
The careers in publishing, you know, it could range from editing, where you work on manuscripts, you work on the language, mm-hmm. you work on the grammar. For that, you know, your language skills need to be very, very good. So there's editorial. Then there's also, if you're a designer, mm-hmm. You can work with a publishing company because we have designers on board who work on our covers, who set up the covers. Then there are typesetters, who typeset manuscripts to give them the form right. that you see in the printed book. There are also marketing professionals. Mm-hmm. We have an entire department that is purely dedicated to marketing.
Okay.
Because whenever each book is published, mm-hmm. We create a marketing plan for it.
Right.
And we execute that plan through the publicists who work mm-hmm. with us. So I think that there are so many possibilities, of course, that exist in publishing. It's right. not just somebody who's editing mm-hmm. or who's, who knows grammar well or something. You
right.
you can also be a marketing professional or a designer mm-hmm. or, there's so many other different ways in right. which publishing houses require mm-hmm. people. These days also digital marketing has become very very prominent, and right. Especially during the COVID years, mm-hmm. A lot of our marketing activities shifted online,
mm-hmm.
and a lot of digital platforms, we became very mindful of those, and we mm-hmm. started using them a lot more. So
isn't the book, the hardbound books are taking a place because of this digital advent of technology, and people are more inclined towards the technology. So isn't it taking a little bit hit? I mean, is it hitting the industry bad?
Not at all. I think that, in fact, after COVID, during COVID, what we saw that people started reading again.
Okay.
A lot of people who had gotten out of the habit of reading actual books started mm-hmm. reading again, because, there's only that much of Netflix you can watch, or only right. that much. And people were at home all mm-hmm. the time. You couldn't go out anywhere.
Right.
So a lot of people started reading again. Books got, I think, another sort of lease of life in that sense.
Right.
But, actually, this is a good question, because periodically, the book has, the book has been declared dead periodically.
Mm-hmm. Right.
But it always bounces back, because I think it's an enduring medium.
True.
In many ways.
True. And how did you start your journey?
My journey has been through journalism mm-hmm. and through the media world mm-hmm. and through, so I've always been a very big reader, very mm-hmm. avid reader since my childhood.
Right.
And I think that love for books always mm-hmm. was there.
Right.
Professionally, I worked in different capacities before mm-hmm. I got into publishing, and that sort of then gave me a chance to not just read books, but also explore the whole ways in mm-hmm. which books are actually made,
mm-hmm.
how they are written, how they are edited, how they are typeset, how mm-hmm. they are how an idea becomes a book, actually.
True.
So that gave me an opportunity working in publishing.
Right. And what are the plans, like you want to continue in this field only, or in future you have some other plans?
I would like to continue in this field, and there is a lot more. I work primarily with nonfiction, and I think this is a very good time for nonfiction because there are so many issues, topics that require, you know, greater research, and there are also, you know, historical subjects, and you know, there are various subjects that need to be, I think people need to write books about.
Which is your favorite?
My favorite subject? My favorite subject, I think, would be politics and history. I think these two subjects, I think we publish a lot in these areas, and also because the space, you know, the physical space for a lot of writing on these subjects is shrinking.
Right. If we look, I was about to say, because you chose a very difficult one.
Because in the media space, if you see, the actual physical and newspapers have shrunk. Magazines have very little space. So, you know, where is, and digital media, sure, it has space, but nowhere do you see the kind of, you know, in-depth, long-form writing that a lot of historical subjects or political subjects require. And that's why I think publishing books in these areas is very important, because it gives the chance for research in topics that people need to read about and want to read about.
Nowadays, ChatGPT is available.
Yeah.
So I would like to take your point of view, especially for the young masses, you know.
Yeah, yeah.
So I personally believe it's not good for them to use it, especially at a young age and at the entry level.
Yeah, right? Yeah.
So what is your take on that?
I think that I agree with you. I think we're also at a point where we need to figure out ways in which to use AI and not be used by it, if you know what I mean. That whether it's publishing or as writers or even in many other professions, how do we use this to our best advantage as human beings in terms of exploring the possibilities before us to, you know, better conditions for living conditions and so on for our fellow countrymen and country people, rather than, you know, becoming enslaved by it in many ways.
But it does not amount to plagiarism, right? If somebody is using it. Is it?
Plagiarism would not be, because plagiarism is when you take without attribution something that has previously been published or written by somebody else. So, for example, if there's an article or there's a section in a book that somebody just lifts from there in an existing publication, and they just use it without attribution.
No, or so without, what I meant is that if somebody is taking the content from ChatGPT also, it doesn't, you know, stands in tantamount to the plagiarism kind of thing, right?
It's not plagiarism, I think, but what I think it does amount to is it's not your original content.
Exactly. So does it, does the industry accept that? I mean, if somebody is taking content from ChatGPT, is it acceptable?
I don't think so, because, you know, we our contracts are with authors, and our contracts are very clear that you know, whatever the author is giving us is something that they have written, and therefore they have the copyright on. And who knows in the future what will happen, but at the moment we don't consider ChatGPT to be acceptable in that fashion.
Right, that's what I meant, because the way is you cannot copy the content from some source, you cannot, you know, use ChatGPT and publish your stuff.
I mean, you can't publish it under your name. If you came to me and said, I gave these prompts to ChatGPT and ChatGPT wrote this for me, well, it's never happened.
Let's say he's rephrasing the language by using ChatGPT, that is acceptable?
We don't actually have any policy on ChatGPT as of now. So whatever I'm saying is just coming from my own understanding, or maybe lack of understanding of ChatGPT and so on. But let's see. I mean, it's a developing field, and maybe we should meet at the next.
Yeah, because even I was not clear, and I wanted to give out this message.
Yes,
because the way we have policy and rules in place.
Yes,
not to copy the content from outside.
Yeah,
similarly, if somebody is trying to, you know, kind of rephrase the language by using ChatGPT.
Yeah.
So is it allowed or not? That's what I wanted to
As of now, no, we don't have any policy actually regulating this. But I think it would be, like I said, you know, let's meet next year at the same time and see.
Yeah.
And revisit this question, and maybe I'll have more information for you at that point.
Right. So, what exactly you do in your leisure time? How do you spend your leisure time?
Oh, that's a very good question, because, you know, I read a lot. Okay. So, I read for work because you're reading manuscripts, you're reading books you're working on, you're constantly reading. And in my
leisure
time...
There might be some boring manuscripts also.
Boring,
so how do you like scan them? You know, through the first page you get to know, or you read the entire thing and then you... just reject it or what?
So the way that we look at manuscripts is, yes, I'm usually the first person to look at a manuscript that's come in. Yes, it's very obvious if something does not grab me in the first few pages.
Right.
Not just the first page, but few pages. It's obviously not going to do anything for me.
Right.
But... having said that, because I work in nonfiction, there are also books that have a certain readership.
Mm-hmm.
So, for example, if there's a book on the economy, let's say the state of the Indian economy, there is a certain readership for that.
Right.
It may not be. I publish books on the economy, but I may not be the ideal reader for it, but I still do it because that's part of our, you know, and so we need to. So it's, I think, a question of finding the correct writer, which is that somebody who can tackle that subject and to work with them to develop the idea so that the end product, which is the book, is both readable, informative, and basically a good read. You know, it should not be too heavy or too burdened by academic jargon or too soon, because we are not an academic publisher. I work for a trade publisher, so which basically means that our books are for the general readership. So even if we publish under specialized topics like economics or history or political science or whatever, the book itself needs to be readable by a common interested reader.
So any story which is coming to your mind, some incidents that you would like to share with the viewers?
Can you be more specific as to what kind of incident?
Any of your life story that, you know, just at the blink of your eye you remember it. Some incidents or something which is coming to your mind.
Related to publishing?
Related to your life. It can be personal as well as professional, whatever you feel like.
Okay. No, I think that something like that, I think for me what's very exciting is when I hear about ideas that people are thinking about, and then I'm able to work with them to develop those ideas into a book.
So
I think
did
those
someone come like that?
Oh yes, all the time. That's how. That's what.
Yeah.
Is
so
the high point of my career.
A story, right? So something, someone who you remember till now, and you know, it just clicked at that moment only.
Okay. Yeah. No, there are several like that. Like. I can give you two very quick examples. So one is Mr. Vikram Sood, who's a former chief of the RNAW. And I happened to meet him at a social gathering, and I said, sir, you've headed the RNAW, you should write a book. And he said, well, I'm not going to talk about India's spying operations and all that. I said, no, sir, of course not that, but is there something we can talk about? And he said, sure. So the conversation started from that point. And I have now published two books that he has written. The first was called, both of them actually look at geopolitics and how India has, India's actions have played out or things have happened to India and how India has responded. So it's they're basically India and the global world kind of aspect, and they have nuggets, you know, of they have certain jewels in them that only he would know,
right.
You know, because of who he was.
Right.
So things like that when they happen, right, and books come together, it's always a pleasure.
Great. So a quick rapid fire, I think we can do.
Sure.
Right?
Sure.
Starting with your date of birth.
My date of birth, 17th February.
Okay, we'll wish you happy birthday.
Thank you.
Yeah. No, advance, I think it's
about it's going to come.
Yes,
yeah,
right,
yeah.
Advance. And your favorite cuisine?
My favorite cuisine. This is not rapid fire. I have to think about it because I like so many. But I think anything that's well made.
That's rapid fire, that you have to be quick and
okay,
figure out which one is that.
Well made, flavorful, not too heavy, anything.
Okay, your favorite brand in terms of your bags, maybe?
The bag that I have with me right now is from a place called Chandi Mati, which does handmade, stuff.
So handmade is your favorite?
Absolutely.
Great.
Any day.
And had you not been in the publishing house, what you would have been doing? If Swati not in publishing house, then what?
A writer.
Oh my God. Great.
Yeah.
And any funny moment that you can describe in two words?
Two words. Any funny moment? That's very difficult. This is the most difficult. I think it's mostly to do with in my work. It's mostly to do with times when we have discussions about new books, mm-hmm, and there is a lot of because we look at everything, okay, internally. So I think there's a lot of fun and jokes when certain kinds of manuscripts are discussed. But I'm sorry, I can't tell you.
No, I shouldn't do that. So what? So we omit this question. Fine, it will not be included.
Yeah.
So what is that one quality that your parents like about you?
Oh my God, my parents, I think creativity.
Oh, wonderful. Great. So, wish you all the best and thank you so much for sparing out your time for us.
Thanks
a ton. It was lovely meeting you.
It's been a pleasure. Thank you.